prominent Republicans have been rethinking their party's ironclad opposition to new tax revenues in the aftermath of last week's election. And Democrats are now considering one of Mitt Romney's proposals, imposing a hard cap on income tax deductions to target the affluent. Tennessee Senator Bob Corker is a member of the Banking Committee and has been negotiating, I think, with the Gang of Eight or Six or whichever gang you're in right now. Senator, thank you very much. You're one of those people who've been reaching across the aisle trying to come up with a solution to this fiscal cliff. And I want to talk to you about that in just a moment. Can I just ask you, before we proceed, you're also on the Foreign Relations Committee. What do you think of what has transpired with General Petraeus, now General Allen, talk of your chair, John Kerry, possibly going to the Pentagon?
A lot of moving parts. Look, General Petraeus is a legend in our state. He's a national hero, and I think all of us are shocked and, you know, certainly all of us thinking about him and his wife. This is a traumatic time for them, but just now it reaches into General Allen. I mean, a lot of questions about the FBI and the timing, and there's a lot swirling around. We actually have a hearing this afternoon on some of the cables that we've received regarding Benghazi. It's a classified briefing, but I'm sure there's going to be a lot of discussion about all these things during that briefing.
Do you think that the intelligence leaders should have been notified sooner of an FBI investigation that was going on for months and months into the CIA director?
I was with Dianne Feinstein. We were both on a Sunday program this week and certainly watched her comments, but talked to her back before we both went on. And it's almost beyond belief that this would be happening and the leaders of our intelligence community would not know that it's happening. So there are a lot of questions. They're multi-layered questions. I will say back, I did listen to the end of your last segment, and I've had very high-level conversations at the CIA over the last several weeks and certainly before, and I still will say that it's almost beyond belief that our ambassador to the UN on the Sunday morning program 5 days later would be talking about this event as if it emanated out of some film. I was in Libya. I think you know that. I was there about Libya, but certainly focused on Benghazi. It was a pre-planned trip, but it was there after the events regarding Benghazi. And Andrea, for what it's worth, there is no question whatsoever that our intelligence officials there on the ground in real time, while it was happening, was letting the highest officials that we have know that this was not a terrorist attack. So getting back to the issue you were talking about in the first segment, I still think there are a lot of questions about the public communications, the public affairs department regarding what happened in Libya, and hopefully we'll talk about that some today also.
Well, I do want to ask about that, because do you think that Susan Rice could be the next Secretary of State? Do you think that she would enjoy support? The argument from the White House is, why blame her for what intelligence guidance she was given if it was bad talking points?
Yeah, I just, I haven't, I don't know how the talking point came. Again, I've had conversations with the highest levels at CIA, and I think they too are baffled by the communications that took place on that Sunday by the ambassador. So I think a lot would depend on let's see what those talking points, let's see what was coming from the CIA and the DNI and others. So I think there's a lot that needs to be known before you would ever know whether this is somebody that's confirmable, because I think still, you know, the three segments to Benghazi, the before, what happened that evening, and what happened after, I still, again, it's beyond belief to me that we'd have public officials out characterizing this event the way they did 5 days after the event. So again, I think it depends on us actually seeing these communiques and what was transpiring between the intelligence community and Susan Rice and others. One thing I will say is, you know, Hillary Clinton, who is a very seasoned official, been very mature in her job, you did not see her out on five programs calling this an event that was created by some film by a Coptic Christian in California. So she at least had the savvy to not get herself involved in something like that. And I think these are all questions that would come up if she was put forth. Again, I'm not saying yes or no as an individual senator. I just know there are a lot of questions about it.
I understand it. And okay. Understand that. Now, I want to ask you,